May the blessings of the Triple Gem be upon you all, friends in the Dhamma. Today I would like to bring you a couple of English words to think and to operate your thinking mind. There's no doubt you have thought about it in a certain way. I believe not in this way. In English, there are two verbs. They are, one is to practice. The other one is to happen. Practice and happen. These two words are verbs that signifies kind of activity. In our life, there are some practices, some actions, some activities. We perform them as planned. We have a plan. Intentionally, we do practice it. Intentionally, to having a plan, we practice it. We do it. That is the kind of practice. The other one is the happening, to happen. What is the difference between these two verbs? To happen something, to take place something, there is no need to plan. It will happen by itself. There's no need to think of it. But in order to practice something, you need to plan. You need to give pre-thoughts. You need to just think about it. What and how and where? There's a planning. To use this word, the practice, you need to have a plan. For the word happen, you no need to worry about it. It will happen in any way. Think of your life. There are some practices and also there are some happenings in your life. We are living in the conceptualized world. This world is full of concepts, conceptualized words, conventional world. We are living in. We are members of this world. So in our life, there are some happenings and also there are some practices necessary. In our lives, happenings are so many. We feel hungry. We feel thirsty. Some sort of physical changes, not practice, but happens. So we need to, take our time for those happenings. And not only that, physical things, think about your mind, mental happenings, and thoughts and thoughts and thoughts flow continuously. You do not have any plan. That habitual thoughts will come to you. Habitual thoughts will flow in the mind. That is happening. Why is that? Why is that happening is in your mind? Because this happening is habitual. For a long period of time, not in this life, not in this life itself, not in this life only. For a long period of time, you have used the worldly concepts. You have used these worldly conventional terms and words. Your mind is habitually with these concepts, quite attached to these worldly concepts. Therefore, habitually these worldly concepts, worldly thoughts, thoughts about the world will flow continuously. You cannot stop it. It will take place whether you like it or not. So you are bound by that habitual thoughts pattern. But there is another word, another verb, that is practice. This is very necessary. The practice will never happen. Practice will never take place. You need to offer and strain your brain, strain your mind. You have to intentionally do practice it. So whatever necessary to do. Why? Because you need to cross over this habitual pattern. You need to get away from these habits. Then what happens? your mind is bound by these worldly concepts, conventional way of thinking, therefore you are in it. There is not any piece of real happiness there. Any bit of real happiness is not found there. Therefore, you have to cross over this habitual ways of thinking. For that purpose, you need to use that verb, practice. What way of practice? Practice means so that you are moving away from this habitual pattern, habitual things, conventional world. That way of practice you should have in your life. The Abhidhamma philosophy will never happen in your life. Abhidhamma study will never happen, will never take place in your life. Abhidhamma study is not happening, it is a practice. Therefore, you need to plan. You need to have extra energy to activate your mind. You need some thought, good thought, to activate your mind regarding these subtle types of teaching, subtle kinds of learning. Habit is a habit. It is quite stuck and strongly adhered in your life. Adhered to your life. You cannot undo it. But this practice, learning, will help you to undo it and get away from these worldly things. So this practice is important. There are types of learning. That is scriptural learning, study of scriptures, and also study of your life. Writing and collecting notes and speaking and listening to talks. This much is not enough for your practice. You need to do some more. You need to, what you learn from this Abhidhamma philosophy, you need to use that practice, that Abhidhamma, to find in your life. For that, you need to have this verb practice. So, happening is not the way to cross over the samsaric journey, but practice is the most important and necessary verb and actions you have to do in order to get away from this journey, get away from this samsaric suffering. For that purpose, I will take my time to share with you. Analyze it. Analysis will never happen in your life. Analysis is to practice. Dividing, analyzing, investigating things in depth, you need to practice. In sutras and Abhidhamma as well, you find a word, a phrase called Dhamma Vichaya. Dhamma Vichaya, that means investigation. Investigate and search for, searching for, seeking for, investigation. You have to investigate. This happening is flowing in your life within and without. But investigate intentionally, with wise attention, investigate it. That is practice. What should be investigated? These worldly things should be investigated. Worldly things, worldly matters, worldly conditions should be divided into small, small pieces, small parts. That is a type of practice. That is what the Buddha taught us. That is the way of learning. That is the way of practice. By that means, we can get away from this samsaric suffering. For that, I wish you all the best. May you get empowered by this Dhamma learning and Dhamma practice. Ultimately, may all of you find the supreme bliss of Nibbana, that is a fine peace. Thank you very much.